Take your mark.
Hut!
We've been competitive, you know, all our lives, playing baseball, football, basketball, tennis. And so this is another kind of competition.
Hi, I'm Betty Ann Bowser. I'm the health correspondent for the PBS NewsHour. And with us today are John and Brad Tatum. They're gold medal winners in the Senior Olympics, and they're both in their 90s, and they still swim three times a week. They're swimmers. How did you guys learn to swim when you were little boys living in Washington, D.C., at a time when the country was very segregated, and I wouldn't think there would be very many role models for you to learn from?
Well, you're exactly right. During that time, we lived way down the bottom, which we call Fortigate Bottom, down by Lincoln Memorial, and there was plenty of places to play and plenty of places to spread out. Anytime we saw woods, we'd go through and examine it. Anytime we see water, we'd go in it. And we used to go in the Lincoln Memorial, and the pool was never deep. It was only about 2.5 or 3 feet deep. We didn't know how to swim, but we would wade, you know. And then as we grew a little bit and spread it out a little bit, we'd go over to the river and watch the older boys, and they'd show you how to dog paddle, they call it.
This is where we start to swim. Couldn't get very far. And it wasn't all slimy and stuffy like it was then.
Yeah. And I used to envision the Olympics being held here because of this pool would be you could swim a mile straight away,
yeah,
in a pool.
I hope they win four first place in the coming Olympics. Here's my wish.
How did you get involved in the Senior Olympics?
After I retired, and I did a lot of gardening, and we had a country home that we used to go to just for recreation. But then we found out that these people were swimming, seniors were swimming, and I used to swim, you know, so I would get into this. So I joined the team, what they call the Water Wizards.
We had local swimming meets for local people, and then we found out that they had swimming meets on a national level. And we were a little trepid about going out there wondering whether we could make it. But we finally went.
How old were you when this was going on?
I was in my 70s.
Mid-70s,
just yeah, about when I first started. Mm-hmm. Back.
Won the first medals in our group in Pittsburgh.
But then we went to Louisville, and he won all the medals. He won the golds, about 5 golds. And then we went to San Francisco. I won 3 gold medals. And I went to Houston and won 3 gold medals. So we started in 2003, and by 2011, we'd been to 5 meets. To find out that I could still use my legs and arms, and it was a new thing. And swimming is something that you can do. You use all your muscles, and your knees don't go out because you're running, or, you know, no strain at all. And it's just a safe sport and a healthy one.
Now, Brad, you've had a little more serious health episodes here in the last couple of years.
Yes, I have.
With cancer.
That's right. And the doctors were looking at me and wanting to operate, you know, on me like a month before one of the swim meets. I said, no, you have to wait until after the swimming meet, then I'll submit to them. And fortunately, it worked out all right that I had cancer removed, and I'm back swimming again, and I feel fine. And it was rather serious, I'm told by my doctors, a rather serious thing, but I managed to get over it.
Looking back, if you could just pick one or two things to advise people on how to live to be 92 and 90, what would those be?
Well, I would just tell them, you can do it. That's the slogan, somebody else's slogan right now. But you can do anything that your body allows you to do. I find that I walk sometime, I might stumble a bit, and I tend to trip a little bit more. You're scared of falling. But you keep on doing what you can do.
What about you, Brad? What's your advice?
I think people need to keep active, you know. Don't sit around looking at TV all the time. Walk. walking is good exercise, and it keeps you going. But you ought to really find things to do that keep you active, and be determined about it. You know, today I'm going to go walk, you know, 1 mile, 2 miles, whatever you have to do, and that's what helps to keep you active.
Well, I want to thank both of you for being with us today, Brad, John Tatum, and many, many more good years.
Well, thank you
so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
Brad, you knew you're number one this time.
Did I do it?
Yeah, you did it. You did it. You are the boss today.